It's the number one Indian mixed martial artist on the planet. This is the debut all of India has been waiting for. It's time for Manga to lead the Indian charge in ONE Championship. Good two-punch combination there for the BFL champion. Gurdasham Manga goes to the inside thigh. Double left hand there from Manga. Oh, boom shakalaka! Nice takedown there from Gurdasham Manga. Outside leg kick there from Manga. Oh, there's the left hand from Manga. Here comes Gurdasham Manga, and he drives down Tauru. The confidence flowing now. He's done the damage to Tauru. Tauru locks onto a leg. Hammer fist strikes. It's all over. Gurdasham Manga wins on debut. That's a huge win for Manga. That's a huge win for Indian mixed martial arts. Final instructions from the 2018 Global MMA Awards Referee of the Year, the boss, Olivia Cost. And this is the debut all of India has been waiting for. Gurdasham Manga and Tony Tauru, brought to you by Rose Garden Hotel Yangon. High left roundhouse kick from Gurdasham early on. So much hype, so much talk for Gurdasham Manga, the BFL amateur champion. 9 finishes as a pro. Whoa.
Tony Tauru's got to be careful coming in like that, throwing those shots. That's how he got knocked out by Bibiano Fernandez coming forward.
And Bibiano Fernandez, the coach of Gurdasham Manga. Tauru, those long arms. The Finn can finish, but so too can Manga. Now we got the grab for the first time. Post up on the left arm. Back to his feet now, Tony Tauru. It's been a long time between drinks for Tony Tauru. Good start here from Manga Gurdasham.
Tony Tauru's catching a lot of those kicks. It may have been a year and a half since he's been in the cage, but he said that time away really allowed him to get involved in coaching, working with a lot of his athletes, and getting better as an athlete himself.
Tony Tauru, Cage Warriors Bantamweight champion. Gurdasham Manga, BFL champion. Two more great martial arts champions in the cage here. 7 world champions on tonight's main card out of over 120 martial arts world champions on the ONE Championship roster. Watch your head. Uppercut short in there. Missed the target for Tauru. Good range on that. Left cross out of southpaw stance for Gurdasham Manga. Saint Lion, they call him. A roundhouse kick from the Cage Warriors Bantamweight champion in the red. BFL champion on the outside. Circling away from the power side of Tauru. Wisely so from Manga. Looks in amazing condition. It's as good as Sean Manga. High up on the balls of his feet. The chin is tucked, looking through the brow. Went for the inside thigh. How Tauru would love to get him down, would love to play the ground game. Good two-punch combination there for the BFL champion, Gurdasham Manga of India.
Nice left hand landed by Manga. He's able to find a home for it. Taru's got to be careful coming in like that. He's got to keep his chin nice and tucked. Follow that jab.
Ooh, trying to come over the top of the short right hook to Tony Tauru there. Cage Warriors champion threads a jab. Gets out of the way of the liver kick from Manga. Manga sticks the jab in the throat. Goes to the inside thigh. Double left hand there from Manga. Flying knee from Tony Tauru. Uppercut from Tauru. Oh, nice takedown there from Gurdasham Manga.
Omoplata attempt here from Tauru. Let's see if he can use to get back up. You can see the omoplata there, the shoulder lock on Gurdasham Manga.
Was it dangerous to take down a finisher on the ground like Tony Tauru?
You know, this is a new weight division for, you know, Tony Tauru. I was a little bit worried when I heard he was dropping the flyweight. He spent a long time. He spent 6 years as a bantamweight. And to come all the way down, to have somebody like Gurdasham Manga on top of you is a tough proposition. But so far, Tony Tauru is a bit more active. He's actually looking good at this weight.
The former Cage Warriors champion, Tony Tauru, the BFL champion. Gurdasham Manga. Manga moving well, switching angles between a southpaw and orthodox. Gets out of the way of that long-reaching jab from the Finn. There's the right hand from Tauru. Boitai clinch a knee from Mungat. Mungat circles away from the power side, away from the right leg, the right hand of Tony Tauru. Mungat Gordon coming in, tries to fold him in half with a knee. Good work on the inside for the BFL champion.
Nice combination by Mungat to end up in that clinch and then throw that knee.
More than 120 martial arts world champions on our roster of 500 plus athletes here at ONE Championship. Mungat fires the left hand, whips upstairs with the high roundhouse kick. Tauru says, try to touch me on the beard if you can. Inside leg kick from Gurdasham Mungat. Neither man wants to give up centre cage here. No signs of ring rust on the Cage Warriors champion, Tony Tauru.
Yeah, Tauru's looking really active at this weight. He's got it, you know, he's nice and light on his feet. He's a lot more active when in the stance. He's throwing a lot of, you know, flying knees. This is a new Tauru. I like the reinvention of the Viking.
Lots of head movement from Tauru, sitting behind the shoulder. Full jab, high lift roundhouse kick there from Gurdasham Mungat, the BFL champion. The Cage Warriors champion misses with two punches on full extension into the first round. Wherever you're watching, 138 countries around the world, it's ONE Championship live from Yangon, Myanmar.
Here's a little bit of action. There's Tauru missing with the straight right hand, but then Mungat came back with almost a Stockton slap, answering with a shot of his own. Again, you can just see Tauru is consistently pushing forward. There's Mungat ducking underneath Tauru and ending up on top. This led to that omoplata attempt by Tauru. You can just see that as soon as Tauru hits the ground, he is immediately attacking the submissions. Mungat refuses to take the stool. Tauru's sitting down.
You're a sitter or a stander, Mitch?
I was a sitter. I take full advantage of that 60 seconds.
Second round set for three between the BFL champion, Gurdasham Mungat, the Cage Warriors bantamweight champion, Tony Tauru. He's also a Finnish national BJJ champion.
Round two.
John debut. Number one Indian mixed martial arts star. Makes his first appearance in ONE Championship, the biggest martial arts organization on the planet. Fake there from Mungat. Up on the balls of his feet again, the Indian. Cracks to the outside, back thigh. Tauru reaching with the lead hand. Mungat changing levels, goes the inside thigh. There's the left hook. Mungat in great shape, ripped, stripped and striated. Look at the size of the delts and the traps on Gurdasham Mungat, the BFL champion.
There's not some good head movement here in the second round. Nice and light on his feet, moving that head off of the center line, not staying in the middle. And he's shifting his head away from the power side of Tauru.
Tauru, who's a Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu Finnish champion, hasn't had the chance to show us much of the BJJ styling so far, Mitch.
You know, he had that opportunity. As soon as Gurdasham took him down, he was immediately attacking. He shows that pedigree and why he is a BJJ champion. Is he attacked with that omoplata? As soon as his back touched the ground, he was attacking. Taru's got a very dangerous guard. No head kick there, landed.
Double leg takedown attempt there from Tauru. Didn't get him down. Bold uppercut from Mungat. Back to their feet. Center cage. 3:40 remains. Second round of three. Mungat in southpaw stance. Resets as the Indian, the BFL champion. Inside leg kick from the BFL champion. Now the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu champion in the red would love to get him down and tie him up like a Finnish pretzel. Body shot there from Gurdasham Mungat. Double jab, roundhouse kick, nicely done from Mungat. Doubles up on the left leg, roundhouse, almost fell into a high knee there from the Cage Warriors champion.
Mungat's having a better round here in the second. He's been a lot more active in the punches.
Overhand right didn't come close there for Tauru. Circles off as Mungat thrusts the jab. Roundhouse kick for the four rounds. Another one from Mungat. Striking contest here in the second round. Good counter right hand there from Tauru. BFL champion Mungat circles off to his right. Throws a good left hand out of southpaw stance. Tauru, lots of head movement. Using that shoulder protection again. A very side-on stance for the Finnish BJJ champion, Cage Warriors bantamweight champion, the BFL champion with the inside thigh kick. Jab to overhand right there from Tony Taurut. At what point, Mitch, does Tony Taurut's corner tell him, go for the takedown, use what your main strength is, let's get Gurdasham Munger on the ground and try and sub him?
I think he has. He's tried a couple of times to go for the takedown, but every time he's tried the takedown, he's been stuck. Mungat's been able to put him, stop the sprawl, really push the head down and get away. So Taru's having a hard time committing to the takedown now because he's getting punished for it. And every time you do try something, every time, because takedown defense is a category of our scoring.
Jab from the Finnish BJJ champion. Long reach on the arms of Tony Taru, returning to the cage after a long absence. As we said, showing no signs of ring rust against the man of one championship debut, Gurdasham Munger of India. High kick, good double forearms guard there from Munger. 1 minute 10 remaining, second round of three on what has been a thrilling night of action here in Yangon, Myanmar. Up next, of course, we're in Tokyo for the first time ever on March 31st. World title bouts on the one night. The biggest card in history goes down at the Kokugikan in Tokyo on March 31st. Plus, add to that, the one debuts of Demetrius Johnson and Eddie Alvarez, plus Andy Sauer versus Johnson Clive Fairtex, the most stacked card in history, Mitch.
A new era, Tokyo, Japan, March 31st. Right now, we're seeing a high-level display of striking shown by Mungat. He's starting to wing from the power. He's landing a lot of shots, and it's causing Tony Taru to switch legs and actually switch stances and get that, because Mungat is just beating that leg up.
The BFL champion circles off to his right, gets out of the way of the front kick, tries to fire the left cross, goes to the inside thigh. Final 10 seconds of the second stanza. Looping right hand there from Mungat. Very wide southpaw stance now on the Indian. Jab from Taru. We're going to go to the towels, and we're going to go to the quarter of the third and final round.
So we saw a lot of action. Most of it was coming from Mungat in this round two. Look at that nice head kick. Barely Taru was able to get his chin up. But again, look at this. Was able to get the takedown, but immediately Mungat pushes the head away, slides the foot out, slides that right leg out, immediately gets back up, and then starts throwing those hands. See, that is good takedown defense, and that's demoralizing for Taru to try to take down your opponent and have them so easily get away, Michael Cimello.
Some damage on the face there of Tony Taru of Finland. Memento Mori tattooed across his chest. Interesting choice of tattoo. Third and final round.
Come here. Guys, you have one round to finish that fight, all right? Let's go. Back to your corner.
The boss, Olivia Cost, the instructions for the third and final. Will it be a successful return for Tony Taru? Will it be a victorious debut for Gurdasham Munger of India? And now we feel a bit more gusto, we feel a bit more pepper. They've upped the intensity here, Mitch.
Yeah, the boss came out and told them that they needed this to finish the match in this round. They got 5 minutes to put it on them. So, and they're trying right now. They're throwing hands.
Outside leg kick there from Mungat. Oh, there's a left hand from Mungat! And he dropped Taru. Taru sprung back to his feet, but here comes the Indian. Here comes Gurdasham Munger, and he drives down Taru. Top position now.
Oh, that's smart by Mungat to hurt him on the feet, drop him with the left hand, and then to swarm all over him and get that takedown.
Top position for Munger.
But I think Tony Taru actually that's in his favor. He's able to recover now. He's going to be able to clear the cobwebs out from that big shot that Mungat landed, which dropped him. And now he's in his world. Now he can start working the guard.
And Mungat, oh, he skips around to the back of Taru. What's he going to do from here? The Indian, he tries a knee. And look at Gudu Sharma. Got the confidence flowing now. He's done the damage to Tauru. Tauru locks onto a leg. Hammer fist strike. It's all over. Gudu Sharma gets wins on debut. That's a huge win for Munga. That's a huge win for Indian mixed martial arts.
Wow, and the way that he did it in the third round to reach down deep after the referee said, you got one round to finish. Manga took it to heart, hurt him with the left hand. I want to see that left hand again. Watch this left hand. Manga slips back, boom, right on the butt, crumbles Tauru. And then the veteran, the kick kicks in. He chooses to take Tauru down, going into Tauru's world, jumping knee up against the cage, and then just starts dropping the hammer fists. What a debut for Gurdasan Mangat.
Amazing scenes of jubilation here for Gurdasan Mangat. The hype surrounding him was enormous. You feel that Indian mixed martial arts is on the brink. It's ready to explode into mega popularity, and this is the man who will lead the charge, no doubt. Gurdasan Mangat. Let's go to Tom now.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 23 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of knockout, Gurdasan Mangat!
That medal around the neck of that man, Gurdasan Mangat, means so much.
Guys, this is Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome ONE Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.